Chiral center is an atom that is attached to four different groups. We represent a chiral center with an asterisk. When an atom has a double or triple bond, it cannot be a chiral center since there are not enough groups. For example, this carbon is not a chiral center because there are only three different groups and we need four different groups for this to be a chiral center. Let's identify the chiral centers in these two examples. Looking at this carbon, we will see if there are four different groups surrounding the central carbon. We have OH, this carbon chain, a totally different carbon chain with an OH group, and a hydrogen. So both of these carbons are our chiral centers. Note, an achiral molecule can still have chiral centers as shown here. This entire molecule does have a line of symmetry, and both parts are the same, making it achiral. In this example, there are actually no chiral centers because there are two methyl groups, and remember, all of the groups have to be different. Note, a chiral molecule does not have to have a chiral center. There is no line of symmetry within this molecule, making it chiral. Okay, to make sure you fully understand everything we just covered, try these two questions and we'll go over the answers in just a little bit. For question one, identify the chiral centers. To find the answer to question one, let's check each carbon and see if there are four different groups. Nope, not enough groups. Not enough groups for the next carbon. This carbon has 1, 2, 3, 4 different groups, so yes, this is a chiral center. Next, remember a double or triple bond will never be a chiral center, so this one is not a chiral center. This next carbon doesn't have enough groups. The next carbon has 1, 2, 3, and 4 different groups, so yes, this is another chiral center. And this N carbon is a common mistake. It has enough groups, but there are two of the same groups, our methyl groups. But we need all four groups to be different, so this is not a chiral center. There are only two chiral centers in this molecule. For question two, label each molecule as chiral or achiral. To find the answer to question two, remember, we are looking for lines of symmetry. If there is a line of symmetry within the molecule, then it's achiral like this first one is. Here is another hidden line of symmetry. We can count the number of carbons on either side and see that we can cut this molecule in half and it would be the same. Since there are 1, 2, 3 carbons on the left and 1, 2, 3 carbons on the right, making this molecule achiral. Now for the remaining molecules. There is no line of symmetry. No matter how we try to cut them down the middle, they are never the same. So these both are chiral. You can find other helpful videos right here. And if you would like additional homework help, tutoring, or other resources, you can find that all in the description box. And remember, stay determined, you can do this.